Chris Jordan posted a maiden first-class century and then took two early wickets as Sussex gained the upper hand against Essex. Sussex began the day on 291 for 6, 67 runs behind Essex's first innings total and with four wickets still in hand. Archer and Jordan were the not-out batsmen, having already put on 118 runs for the seventh wicket, and both players got into their stride early on. Archer, playing in his first-class match, was finally dismissed for 73, caught behind off the bowling of Masters, his partnership with Jordan worth 140. Briggs was the new man in, and along with Jordan they took the score past Essex's total of 358. Jordan then brought up his first-class 100 in his 80th match with a boundary off Moore. Briggs departed in the next over for 49, LBW to Napier, after a partnership worth 93 with Jordan. Finch fell to Napier for 5, and then Jordan was the last man out, caught Moore, bowled Napier for 131. Sussex all out for 448 after being 173 for 6. Ed Joyce put in a solid shift at the top of the order, but it was the partnerships between Jordan and Archer, and then Jordan and Briggs, that allowed Sussex to build a first innings lead of 90. Jordan, having just come off the field after a total of 5 hours spent at the crease, then took a wicket with his fourth ball of the innings, Brown caught by Joyce for 1. Wesley looked to go on the attack, and built well alongside partner Micklebrough. Micklebrough fell though for 12, LBW to Archer. Lawrence wasn't looking to hang around, launching Archer for 6, before he and Wesley began to build a solid partnership. That partnership was ended on 47 though, when Lawrence was trapped LBW by Jordan for 29. Wesley pressed on and looked to be heading for a half century before Wise had him caught at the wicket for 44. Tenderscarter and Foster then came together and put on 52 to see the hosts through to stumps. Essex finished the day on 163 for 4, a lead of 73 runs with 6 wickets remaining. An intriguing final day on offer in this match, with both sides still in with a chance of victory.